right, so the other day I made these candied pumpkins and I really, really love them. And the more I got thinking about them, so what I did is I poured them with Floetrol and paint. I'm gonna show you how to do that today. And then I put resin over them. But I'm gonna show you how to do the Floetrol part today. And the more I got thinking about the little pumpkins, I thought, what else can I do? And I started thinking about the squash and how I think it looks like a ghost or a goblin. So today I'm gonna try out a goblin because I can and nobody can stop me. All right, so what I did is I just did a base coat, just kind of whitewashed it. And I did that because when you start pouring your paint over, you're just not gonna get complete coverage over it unless you brushed it, and then that would take the pour effect off. So I went ahead and did that underneath. So what you're gonna wanna do is, I already pre-poured, I'm gonna do white for the ghost, and then I'm gonna do a little bit of the metallic blue to kind of give it a shimmery ghost appearance, I'm hoping. I've never tried this before, so. And then you're gonna need Floetrol. Floetrol you can get at your local Home Depot or Lowe's. I think you can get it on Amazon too. I can't recall, but I picked mine up at Home Depot. You'll see I have this beautiful stocking on it, and the reason I have that on with rubber bands is because Floetrol can become chunky, I guess. I haven't had it happen to me personally, but they say if you do the stocking on here, then it always flows through and you don't have those chunks. So every time I use it, I just shake it up, and I've had this for a few months. And then you're gonna want to do the formula that I've followed, and there's many formulas out there. I am not an expert. I will tell you all the time, I could very well be wrong. So, but this is how I do it. So I do as even part as possible of Floetrol and paint. And again, I'm not gonna be precise, but I don't measure this out, but I try to do one part Floetrol, one part paint when I'm doing it. And then you're gonna add a little bit of water. And then I have to go find a stir stick. I believe I have everything here and I forgot to buy stirrers. So bear with me here. Unbelievable. I forgot stirrers at the store. So anyway, that's okay. I have these wonderful skewers in the kitchen that I can use. So you just want to mix it up like so. And it looks plenty runny. I don't see that as a problem. And then you can put a couple drops of alcohol in it. And that's just supposed to open it up and give it cells. I have to be honest, I have not seen the cells on the pumpkin. I have seen it when I do it on my rocks. I have not seen it on my pumpkins. And there's two schools of thought with that. You can use the alcohol or you can use silicone. And I have silicone in the other bottle, and no matter what, either one, I have not seen much cell action at all on the pumpkins, and I'm not quite sure why. So I'm gonna go ahead and get the blue going too. So we're kind of ready to go on all fronts here. A little bit of water. A little stirring it up. And with this one, I'll do the silicone. Silicone, however you would like to say it, versus the alcohol. But again, I haven't seen a major difference with the pumpkins and the squash. I just haven't seen any cell action. Okay, so those seem to be fine. All right, so now what we're gonna do is we're gonna bring our squash over, and I have it sitting on the plate because it's gonna be messy, of course. And then you're just going to, let me see if my camera's lined up okay for this. I need to scoot it back a little bit more, it looks like. So you're just going to pour it over your ghost, like so, and just let it run off. One of the complaints that people have in regards to pouring is that a lot goes to waste, and that's really true. Now, one thing I could do right now is I could put another plate under here, move the squash, and then pour the blue, and then I would at least have that white salvageable down there. But this is such a light blue that I think it will be fine down there, and I can probably even take all of that and pour it over the next ghost with no problem. So now I'm going to pour the blue over it. And again, you just want this, we're hoping that we're just gonna get this shimmer over your ghost. See, as it's pouring down, it's becoming more translucent. So we're just gonna hope as that continues to pour down that it will become more ghost-like, and then I'm gonna pour some white back over it. And that blue should kind of seep through a little bit, is my hope. Again, this is first time trying this, so we really don't know what's gonna happen, but that's my hope. So we're gonna let that dry and run off and see how close I am to accomplishing what I was attempting to accomplish. All right, I'm gonna shut you off. Okay, here we go. Just more repeat of what we've been doing. Hope you're enjoying this as much as I am. And if you're not, I'm so sorry. Change the channel. Gosh, I really do love art though. That we can create one-of-a-kind items, that we're not machines. Okay, now I'm gonna move it over to the blue plate. Move the white plate over because we're gonna reuse that paint. Alexa, volume 2. Sometimes Alexa gets loud. Sometimes I think she has a mind of her own. She's a bit sassy sometimes. I don't know if you guys have an Alexa, but I use mine an awful lot. Okay, now we're gonna move this over to the red plate. Some red on it. Pretty fun. Now, I'm not crazy that there is a huge white piece on one side and another smaller white piece on another. I don't know if I can go through and correct this. I'm gonna try, but this is all a new adventure, so I could have really just messed that up right now, but we'll have to find out later. I'm gonna pour a little bit more here. Hopefully that will be okay. It'll be a good test to know if you can come back in and do that. And the beauty is I'm learning that, not you. not sure where everybody's from on the forum. I know we have people from all over the world, but I live in southern Arizona, and it is spectacular weather-wise right now. It's, high 70s, maybe hits 80. In southern Arizona, we have a nice breeze that comes through all the time. And yeah, I might be saying that a bit sarcastically because sometimes the wind here is the barking dog. Let me tell you, there are days when I really don't enjoy or appreciate everything that the wind does for us, but it is much more pleasant in southern Arizona down below Tucson than it is in Phoenix. I lived in Phoenix for 10 years and it was so miserably hot in the month of August. We had a swimming pool up in Phoenix too, but in the month of August, you could not even get in your swimming pool, and I'm not joking. It was like bath water, and we had friends that if they were gonna have a pool party, they would go buy a truckload of ice at Ready Ice, which is the big ice house in Phoenix, and fill their pool with Ready Ice so the pool would be cool enough for everybody to have a good time at the party. So down here, that is not the case. We get in our pool around April and we swim into maybe October without a heated pool is kind of where you land. But it's beautiful. We cool off 30 to 40 degrees at night and it's just very pleasurable. I'm an Arizona native, and I never knew how wonderful southern Arizona was. I lived in western Arizona as a child, and then after I grew up, we lived in LA for a while, and then in Portland, and then when we moved back, we moved to the Phoenix area, which is central Arizona, and it is miserably hot there. They can have it. Cement city and miserably hot was not my cup of tea. Okay, so I see another area here where there wasn't quite enough white. And since I'm at the end of doing, this is my last pumpkin I'm doing today, I'm just gonna go ahead and pour all this right in here. I don't really care if it mixes at this point. So I hope this has been helpful to you guys. And if you have any questions, please just ask. We're here to help each other. I think the most wonderful thing about the art community that I've found anyway, and I spent a decade in tech, which was highly competitive, and I spent another decade in nonprofit. Those were two very, very different sectors. And I have to say that the art community is so helpful, is so good about sharing. I want it to be extremely clear that by all means, you can copy anything that I do. I have no issues with it whatsoever. We're all here to learn from one another, and I am fully okay with that. There is some artists that aren't, and I totally, respect their opinion on that, but I am not of that because I believe that we all have to learn from somewhere. So that's my belief, and so feel free to do this, and feel free to ask questions, and feel free to share it with your friends. I just think art is meant to be shared. All right, have a good day, everybody. Good morning, guys. Okay, so my pumpkins are done, and I'm going to show you. Since I didn't resin them in front of you, I'm kind of just going to talk about it a little bit here, because it would have been just make the video even longer, and I already know it's incredibly long. So what I use to resin these pumpkins is I use art resin. So what you do is you mix equal parts in a cup. So whatever part, if you put two ounces of this, you do 2 ounces of this. You mix it for 3 minutes in a cup. Then you put on gloves and you simply rub it over whatever you're doing. If it's pumpkins, if it's rocks, whatever you're doing, you just rub it completely over it. Now, what I've learned from these pumpkins is, although my nail bed is awesome for rocks, it's not the best for pumpkins, because the next morning there will be a little bit of stick when you move it off. So what I highly suggest to you is, if you're doing the pumpkins or these wonderful little gourds that I did, do them on parchment paper, because when you pull them off the next morning, they pull off really, really smooth and you don't have any issues. Okay, so once you resin these and you let them dry, they have to dry for around 6 to 8 hours before you can touch them. You have to wear gloves when you work with resin. And then what I did is, bear with me, I'm walking across the room here, I'm sorry, is I used Glossy Accents. You can get this on Amazon. It's a clear dimensional medium. It provides a gloss finish, but I use it to glue my resin on, and I use really super fine glitter. That's just my preference. So once these are resined and dried, then I just do a strip of the Glossy Accents down every other vein of the pumpkin. Not each one, because you want them kind of, you know, Halloween's kind of spooky, kind of mystical. So I don't want complete coverage. I want it to look a little bit rustic. So you put the resin down every other vine or vein of the stem, and then you sprinkle glitter over a paper plate to get some coating, and then you let them dry. If you do this outside, it's probably going to take a half hour or so. Inside, these have been about an hour, and you can touch them now. So that's how you do it. You know, every pumpkin is going to come out extremely unique. You know, these are not mass production pumpkins, and I just love them. You can see there is some cell that comes through, but like when you do on the canvas with the pores, you end up with like the circular cells. This just gives more of a break in it, which is really kind of cool. And then these were gourds. Again, I did these for University of Arizona prize items to be auctioned off at my son's carnival. So I did the U of A on it. And this one, I just took the leftover pour from these pumpkins and I poured it over this gourd. That's why you see a little bit of red and blue kind of seeping through. That's how I did that one. So it was just the leftovers of these pumpkins sitting in the bottom of the plates I reused on this guy, and I think he came out really cute. And then this one here, and again, these here are butternut squash. You can get them at any grocery store. And I thought they were just the perfect shape for these little ghosts. And here I have this one holding a little lantern. He's getting ready to go trick-or-treating. And then when I was rubbing the resin, he was the last guy I did. And I picked up glitter from somewhere else. So there's a little bit of glitter on this ghost too, but it doesn't matter. He's a messy ghost. I love him. So again, here's another one. This was the first one that I did the other day. And yes, you're gonna be throwing them in the trash afterwards. They're gonna turn into mush. But I have to be honest, I live in Arizona. And when we cut and carve our pumpkins and sit them out in 100 degree weather, we throw them out anyway. We don't end up baking them and toasting the seeds and doing all that. So I'm already wasteful. And this way, hopefully, I can help brighten somebody's day, and hopefully we'll raise a little bit more money for teachers at my son's school. Education's really important. And that's it. I hope this is helpful. The other thing, when you're resining rocks or pumpkins or anything, when you first put the resin on, you're going to have little tiny bubbles and you're going to want to hit it. I use a heat gun, and you just hit it with a heat gun and the little bubbles will dissipate. If you don't have a heat gun, you could use a straw to blow. You could use a hairdryer on a low setting, but I have a heat gun. They're like $10 on Amazon. So that's it. I hope it's helpful. I'm sorry it's so long. I didn't even have music for you for the last portion, so you either hate me or love me for that. I'm not quite sure. But these are new. I have no idea how long they'll last, but I think they're just really cute. And can you imagine doing these for a child's princess party and doing them in pink and purple and glitter, or doing Thanksgiving ones to do a Thanksgiving scape on your table and put give thanks on them? There's just endless possibilities of what you could do. They're not economical, I have to say, because you know, these pumpkins, you're looking at probably paying, the cheapest I could find them was $1.80 at Walmart. At Safeway, they were almost $3, so they're not inexpensive to do. You know, resin's not inexpensive. Floetrol runs about $9 or $10 a bottle for the Floetrol. It goes a long ways, obviously, with your cheap acrylics. So they're not inexpensive to do, but they are unique, and I think they're beautiful, and I hope this was helpful. And that's it. Have a great day, everybody.